tuples, tuple literals, tuple deconstruction. Do you know what I'm talking about? The tuple syntax is far from new in C#, yet I see many programmers who are actively ignoring them. Is that your attitude too? Do you believe you should continue writing your code without tuples? Give me 10 minutes and I will show you what you are missing. It's not just the syntax. It is a new programming style in C# which you should be aware of. There are 3 steps to knowing tuples and I will lead you through them. One is to know what a tuple is, but also what it is not. You will see. You will then learn how tuples are changing the structure of your code, removing the need for helper custom classes. And then in the last part of this video, I will put tuples in the context of a larger operation that includes calculation, sequences, link and whatnot. That is a lot to cover in one short video. So let me jump to the editor where we will open the first topic. What is a tuple? We have had tuples since the .NET Framework 4. .NET Framework, not .NET Core. That was year 2010. But these tuples never caught up. This is the class. It was slow and only had meaningless component names like item 1 and item 2. Fast forward 7 years, .NET Framework 4.7 added value tuples. It is a struct, a fast one, and full of features. C# 7 supported tuple literals with component names. Please note that A and B here are not part of the type. They disappear in the compiled code. However, during the compilation, these names are transferred along and used in places where you access them. The compiler will figure out which component you mean to use. Value tuples also support deconstruction, making assigning components to individual variables easy. Why have a tuple then? You can assign 2 variables simultaneously using the tuple syntax without actually instantiating the value tuple. Did you notice how my code was melting down until it shrank to this? This notation is extremely keystroke efficient. There is more, of course. If we wanted to swap these 2 values, we would use a temporary variable. Loads of code are flooding in again. I should know better than this. You can manipulate multiple variables together using tuple literal syntax, and still, there will be no instances of value tuple anywhere. Alright, that was the tuples 101, the syntax. We move on to redesigning code to use tuples. Can you tell what this code is doing? I will give you a moment to think before I run it and show you. Are you ready? Alright, here is the run. Let me type a value 10 first. Here is the answer. This program has displayed Fibonacci numbers up to the 10th number, 0 based of course. I can try a larger or a few smaller ones, testing the lower extreme. The program is working fine at first glance. But I have objections. One is clarity and the sheer size of this code. The second issue is correctness. There's a bug here. Let me address the length issue first. One line of code less if I use tuple literal syntax to initialize state. Not much. But look at the loop's body. When several variables move together in a process controlled by formulas, you can use the tuple syntax again, turning the entire state transition into one formula. I have just cut my code in half. Now, this is an opinionated implementation. I have my opinion, I like it this way. Some other programmers have their own opinions and they don't like this. But I have a bigger insult for them. I'm right, they are wrong. And I plan to prove that. Watch me do that. That will bring us to the main point of tuples. Tuples teach you the virtue of putting the values that are related together. The values that belong together will come together. We used to create classes for that. This one binds the two values into one object. Why not also implement an operation that advances the Fibonacci pair by one step? This is a lovely little model I can use in the loop above. But why? I mean, I have ended up with a ton of code again. This class is showing one problem that gives object-oriented programming a bad name. Verbosity. I'm making one lousy addition, yet it takes up half of my screen space. I want a short and expressive code in which variables that come together go together. That is the request. Why am I putting so much emphasis on that aspect of the design? What do you think? It is because of the bug I have in this code. Back to the terminal, where I will type one more case, the Fibonacci number 100. Surprise, surprise, there's a handful of integer overflows here. I had that same issue in the class below. Look, this addition may overflow. Will some defensive code help? This is so object-oriented, it reminds me of my first job. It also reminds me of my motto, when you have to defend, you have already lost. Watch my course about defensive coding at Pluralsight if you want to learn more. There is the link to that course in the description. Here is the short version of it. What does this class do? It fails. What use is a class that fails? I want code that works when I call it, not that throws back when I make a call. I will now show you the code that works, and I will base it on tuples. I will be deleting this code and writing it over again. You can find all the code I delete during this demo in this helper class here, and you can also download this entire source code if you join me on Patreon. Please support my channel by joining the growing community on my Patreon page. That will give you access to all the source code for all the videos on my channel and more. You can also join the Discord server associated with this channel to participate in discussions and learn more about C# and .NET. Now, to the third and the most complex use of tuples within the context of a larger operation. There will be the function that returns pairs of values, the zero-based ordinal number and the corresponding Fibonacci number, hence tuples. But look what I will call it, get Fibonacci sequence. The only upper bound to numbers in this sequence is the int type. It will all begin mildly by yield returning the initial pairs and initializing the loop state, and then it will begin. The loop will do the defense, only this time by not throwing any exception. It will just end before it goes too far. This loop is safe by design. How do we use this then? Start from the entire sequence. Take until reaching n, format appropriately. I know that this is not a valid business application, but the process is still valid in any application, including business applications you might be developing. You will always follow this process when you work with sequences and also with tuples. Let the sequence guide you in the right direction and use tuples to transfer multiple values together. That is the principle. Keep related values together. If you don't have a type for that, use a tuple to do it. What if we wanted a single element from the sequence? This won't work because such an element might not exist. This call might throw again. Will defensive coding return to my design? Seek the desired element, format it accordingly, provide a fallback value. Then take the first element which we know exists this time. This code will work every time with not a trace of defensive branching in it. It is defended by design. Let me run this version. It works fine for small numbers. It works fine for medium numbers. Let's try with the overflow. Oh, it has survived. This is a good solution. Let's wrap up this demo. I wanted to avoid anything that may look like this. A large piece of code that throws whenever it cannot complete a request. It is bad on two accounts. I used tuple literals to write a condensed piece of logic that never fails. I also used actual tuples to convey multiple values to the caller without the need to create new custom types for that purpose. Consuming the values wrapped into tuples is a matter of using a dot or, if applicable, deconstructing a tuple into variables. That is tuples in action. Again, this is not a business application, this is a small demo application, but the process is identical in any application you might be developing, an application of any size. I hope you will like tuples now after seeing this demo, and I hope you will start using them in your designs.